Dear students, welcome to the EPG Padashala. On the front office housekeeping paper, I'm Dr. Sridevi Sivakami, who is going to delve about the cleaning equipments. The efficient cleaning and the maintenance depend upon the high quality cleaning equipments when it has been correctively used. Though only 5 to 10% of the overall cost incurred on the cleaning is accounted for to purchase the cleaning equipments and the cleaning agents. The selecting the ideal equipment plays a major role in the cleaning process. There will be often be a several ways of carrying out any particular cleaning task and different types of equipments that can be employed for it. It is the responsibility of an executive housekeeper to select the most appropriate pieces of the equipments according to the hotel's requirements. Most types of the cleaning equipments fall under the category of the recycled items, but a few large pieces of the items may be considered as a fixed assets. The correct choice of quality cleaning equipment should save a cost due to the breakdowns, reduce the fatigues, and also ensure the overall efficiency in operations. Equipments used in the cleaning the surface, furniture, fittings in the hotel buildings include the both manual and the mechanical equipments. After reading this module, you should be able to understand the importance of the cleaning equipments in the housekeeping department and to understand the basic function of the cleaning equipments and its mode of operation. Now let us discuss about the manual equipment. As the name indicates, the manually, it has been operated by the human beings. The manual equipments can include all types of equipments that clean or aid in the cleaning process by directly using the operations and the energy of an employees. First type of manual equipments in all the cleaning process is the brushes. They are being designed to remove the dry or the wet or ingrained dust or the dirt from the hard or the soft surfaces. There are different parts of the brushes. You may have seen the bristle in the brushes. These are being made up of the animal or vegetable or the man-made origin. The horse hair, nylon, polypropylene are the commonly used to make the bristles for cleaning brushes. In general, they are finer. Softer bristles are best for smooth and hard surfaces. Harder the bristles, the softer the surfaces on which the brushes should be used. Exception being a toilet brushes and brushes often on all-purpose floor machines. If a bristle is not maintained properly, have to be tendency to bend or fall out of the stock. Bristles should be closely set in stuffs and stock well covered with the stuffs. Here you can see the head stock in the brushes. This part of the brush into which the bristles are being inserted. The stock may be of wood, metal or a plastic. A good brush is one that has a sturdy stock. Another basic part is the handle. The brush handles may be detachable or non-detachable. The detachable handles must be fixed firmly in the place on the stock when the brush is in use. Normally, brushes are being used to clean the surfaces and they are broadly classified into three types: hard brush, soft brush and scrubbing brushes. The first one is the hard brush. In this type of brush, have the bristles that are fairly stiff and well placed out. They are most suitable for the removal of a heavy soil or the litter from the carpet or for cleaning rough surfaces. In case of soft brush, the bristles are fairly flexible and set closely together. This helps to remove the loose soil and lighter on the hard or the smooth surfaces. Such brushes may be designed to dust carpets, furniture, to especially those made on cane or wicker or bamboo. The next type of the brush is the scrubbing brushes. Whereas in the scrubbing brushes have a short coarse bristle designed to use on the surface that have become stained and heavily ingrained with dirt. These brushes should only be used to remove the stubborn heavy soiling form in the small areas that are difficult for scrubbing machine to assess. The long handle scrubbing brushes are called the deck scrub or T-scrubbers are useful for cleaning the large areas, especially in the corners. Here you are seeing a various type of brushes which are being broadly classified on their functions. Toilet brushes, they are being used to clean the western closet. The radiator brushes and the Johnny mops are being used as a toilet brushes. Next one is on the bottle brushes. They are being used for cleaning the overflow vents in the wash basins and the tubs. The cloth scrubbers, they are being used for scrubbing the cloths. The duct scrubber, they are being used for cleaning the large areas. Next one is on the carpet brushes. As the name indicates, it is being used for brushing the carpets. The next type of brushes is the upholstery brushes. They are being used to loosen out the dust embedded between the fabric fibers in the upholstery of the chairs and sofas. The feather brushes, these are brushes which has been made out of feathers of the various birds, especially for lightening the dust. The hearth brushes, these are being used for cleaning the heavy soiling and removing the ash out of the fireplaces. Next one is on the flue brushes, these are being used to clean the chimneys. Similarly, like brushes, the brooms are also used to clean the dirt surfaces. You should have seen a sweeping brooms. This consists of a long bristle gathered together and inserted into a handle. The bristle of the broom may be made up of a grass or a corn or a coconut fibers. Depending on the types of brooms may be used for removing the dust and the dirt in the large areas. As like brushes, the brooms are also be classified into three main categories. The soft bristle brooms, a hard or coarse bristle and wall brooms. Let us learn what is a soft bristle broom. The soft bristle brooms such as a corn fiber brooms or a grass brooms or a whiskey brooms are being used to remove the smooth floors. The good softened brooms has comparatively fewer split ends and any splits that do not form a short one. The second one is the hard or a coarse bristle broom. As the word denotes, the broom has yard brooms and a coconut fiber brooms are being used as a surfaces and it is being used especially in outdoors. The third type of broom is to clean the wall, which has been named as a wall brooms. They are also called as a ceiling brooms or Turk's heads. They have a soft head and a long handle, usually made of cane. These brooms are being used to remove the cobwebs as well as the dust from the corner of the wall, ceilings and high ledges. Apart from the brushes, the brooms, there are some more cleaning equipments that you may have seen it in our daily life is the mop. Again, the mops can be classified into dry mops, the wet mops, the cloths, the container, the sun-dry equipments, the polish applicators, which should also be considered as a cleaning agents. Now, I am going to discuss with you about the dry mops and the wet mops and its type. The dry mops are also used as a dust control mops. These are designed to remove the soil and the dirt from the floors, walls, ceilings without raising, dispatching the dust. These mops generally consisted of the handle to which the metal frame is being attached. The mop head is either inserted into a frame or stretched out according to the type. There are different types of dry mops. Generally, in this slide, you are going to see the four types of dry mops. The mops with imbrended fringes or the mop with the imbrended mops sweepers, static mops and disposable mops. Whereas in the wet or the damp mops, these mops are being used in conjunction with buckets for the removal of the dirt adhering to the surfaces. The mop heads can be made of cotton, sponge or other fiber capable of absorbing the moisture well. This slide projects on the various type of damp mops. The first one is do all mops, Kentucky mops, Fos mops and spongy mops. The next type of the cleaning equipment that normally used in the hotel is the squeezy. The squeezy consists of a long metallic handle and the wooden or rubber blades to remove the excess water from the surface being cleaned. It is effective when followed by mopping with a damp mop. A smaller version is called a window squeezy. Is been used for wiping away water from the windows. The cloth is also considered as a cleaning equipment. The various cloths are used extensively in the wet and the dry cleaning by the housekeeping staff. For efficient and correct usage, cloths may be colored, coded, and it can be given to a well-trained staff for the different purposes. Here you are seeing a different varieties of cloth that has been available for specific purposes. They are the duster, the cloth mittens, swabs, wipes, the floor cloths, scrum, glass cloth, rugs, polishing cloth, wet cloth, chamois leather, which has been obtained from a typical type of goat skin. Next one is on dust sheets, druckets, hearth cloths and bucket cloths. Next concept in the cleaning equipment is the container. To collect all the dust and the dirt, the containers are being used. The work begins much easier and efficient if the staff is being given with appropriate container which is being carried and easy to transport, collect and store the supplies and other items. There are different types of containers. The various types of containers that has been normally used as a cleaning equipments are the buckets, basin or the bowl, dust pans, dust bins, and carts and trolleys also come under a container, because nowadays we are being able to see a dumping a soiled cloth, and that carts have to be moved from one place, especially from the guest room to the laundry. Now I am going to discuss in detail about the mechanical equipments. As the terminology indicate, they are usually operated by the electricity or gas. The housekeeping staff should be well trained in the operation of these equipments, since incorrect usage will not only lead to an inefficient cleaning but may also become a safety hazard. Do you know the different brand names of the mechanical equipment that is being used in the hotel? Yes. Some of the brands are the Eureka, Forbes, Roots, Tusky, Cratchers. These are the branded names that has been commonly used given to the cleaning equipments. Have you observed the different types of cleaning equipments in a hotel? Yes, you may have seen different types of vacuum cleaners. The vacuum cleaners are also named as a suction cleaner because it just sucks the dust from the floor or from any other surfaces. The vacuum cleaner removes the dust or the soil or the water from the surface by suction mechanism. All vacuum cleaners work on the same operating principle. In all types, the motor drives are impeller, which sucks the air through an inlet and creating a difference in the pressure between the air within and outside the machine. The air drawn in from the inlet passes through the out of the machine. The air drawn in from the inlet passes through and out of the machine. Usually, the air is being sucked together with the soil, the turbs or the water. The dust is being collected into a container provided, which may be within the body of the machine or the outside in the form of a bag. The dust collecting apparatus is a heavy duty models used in a hotel properties, usually consist of two types of dust bag. The inner bag has been made of disposable paper and the outer one has been made of the fabric. Let us discuss about the various types of vacuum cleaners used as a cleaning equipment. First one is on dry vacuum cleaners. These are used for removing the dust and the small pieces of dirt from the floors, the upholstery, furnishing, walls and ceiling. Those using a flexible hose come with the attachments such as a floor cleaning head, a power head or the cervix cleaning head or the upholstery cleaning head, dusting head and extension tube. The next type of a vacuum cleaner is the electric brooms. This will be very light in weight without a motor driven beater brush. As you see in this picture, they are used only for light vacuuming and for touch-ups on carpets and hard floors. The another type is the dusties. In this slide, you can see a small piece of the dusty that is being used as a cleaner. The lightweight vacuum cleaners used for cleaning the curtains, upholstery edges, mattresses, computers and music systems. They clean by brush and suction and are very easy to handle. They may be carried in a hand and strapped to back to the operator. Here in this picture, you are seeing a backup vacuums. They are very efficient to clean a high, hard to reach areas. The vacuum unit in these machines can easily be strapped to back the operator. These machines have a hand-led wands that come with the various attachments for flexibility in cleaning. They are ideal for the use of curtains, draperies, ceiling corners. These vacuums are also referred to as piggyback vacuums. The next type of the vacuum is upright vacuums. These vacuums are at once more frequently seen in the hotels, suitable for the use of the large carpeted areas. The main body of the vacuum lies horizontal on the floor and it is driven by a single motor. The dust bag is outside the machine main body. There is a belt driven beater brush to facilitate remove of the dust from the thick pile carpets. In an improved variation, there is a dual motor system. One motor drives the beater brush, another provides the suction. The machine also has built in the hose for cleaning the corners and upholstery. The next type of the vacuum is a cylindrical vacuum. They do not have a rotating brushes and work by the suction only. The term suction cleaner is generally used by these kinds of vacuum cleaners. The filter cum diffuser is fitted at the outlet, which removes the fine dust and the microorganism from the flow of air passing through the outlet. The filter cum diffuser also reduces the air disturbances and the noise. The dust bag is inside the cylindrical body of the vacuum cleaner. The flexible hose along with the different attachment is being used to clean a variety of surfaces. Now you are going to watch the vacuum that is being commonly used to clean the guest room. The first one is the pipe lifter vacuum, centralized vacuum and the wet and dry vacuum cleaners. Now I am going to discuss about the care and storing the cleaning equipments. The vacuum cleaners will give a maximum cleaning efficiency when they are maintained well. The housekeeping staff need to be trained in the care and maintenance of the machine. The wheels of the machine need to be oiled periodically. After use, the dust bag should be checked and emptied. If the machine has been operated with the dust bag fully, the cleaning will not be operated. The machine may heat up too much and the bags may get damaged. Check the filter after use. If the machine is meant for dry suction only, never use it to clear even a little amount of water, else the dust bag will be damaged. The squeeze should be wiped clean and replaced whenever necessary. The next type of the mechanical equipment is the floor maintenance machine, which is nothing but the scrubbing and polishing machine. These are been designed for scrubbing, buffing, brushing, scarfing and spray maintenance. First one is on the scrubbing. The bristle tips of the brush or the surface of the pad will cut the soiling to remove it. Next one is the buffing. The bristle tips of the brush or the surface of the pad create a high gloss finish on the floor surface. In case of the surface on which the polish has been applied, it will involve generation of a local heat to harden the waxes and the resins. The next one is the burnishing. The tip of the brush or the surface of the pad apart and cut the flow surface to create a smooth surface with a glossy finish. In case of a polished surface, it will involve the removal of the surface layer of polish. The next one is the scarfing. The bristle tip or the edge of the cutting the tool cut into impacted soiling and remove it by the means of a sellish like action. Next type of cleaning equipment is called as a spray cleaning. As the name indicates, the spray mechanism is being applied. This is applied to the maintenance of the floor where a buffable or semi-buffable polish has been applied and the bristle tips of the brush or the surface of the pad removes both soiling and the surface layer of the polish to leave a smooth glossy surface. These machines consist of one large or several small brushes that revolve and scrub the floor. Water and detergents are released from the tank attached to the machine. These machines can be used for shampooing the carpets, polishing the floors and spray maintenance. Such general purpose machines are preferred in many establishments as the machine can be put to a greater surface due to its versatility. Next mechanism involved in the manual equipment is on the wet extracting system. These machines are used to restore the surface appearance of the carpet, upholstery and the curtains. They remove more deeply embedded foliage not easily removed by the suction cleaning. They are useful in the application of soil retardant finish on the carpets. Let us move on to the various type of waste extraction system. First one is on hot water extracting machine, solvent extracting machines and the carpet shampooing machines. Here in this slide you are seeing four broadly groups of carpet shampooing machines are the steam extracting machine, cylindrical brush dry foam machine. Next one is on the rotatory brush wet shampoo machine. The last one is on the small rotatory brush wet shampoo machines. The last aspect in the mechanical cleaning equipment is the scarfing machines. The scarfing is the process by which a heavy grease, mud, wet sawdust and thick deposits are removed from the surface of the floor. The process is employed when simple scrubbing has been ineffective. Here, dirt deposits are broken up by sellery-like action of a wire brush cutting tool. A storage, distribution and control of the cleaning equipment is very important. All the housekeeping equipment must be stored under the lock and key. To summarize this module, cleaning procedure depends solely on the cleaning equipments. In every hotel, a huge amount of the money is being invested in the purchase of the different types of cleaning equipments. In this module, you have learned how cleaning equipments are broadly classified and its mode of operation either by manual or mechanical. You may also learn about the different types of cleaning equipments which have to be handled done in a proper way in order to reduce the fatigue of the employee, to reduce the energy in while we operate the machine and how effectively it have to be operated for while operating the each equipment. Manual procedures have to be given to a housekeeping personnel while employing the staff. The housekeeping staff, a proper training have to be employed.